Some people might find the topic today a little disturbing, so we want to give you a heads up. As we discussed in yesterday's Vortex, we're going to spend a few episodes on the topic of masturbation. Because a very large number of young viewers, many of them male, do it routinely, continually, over and over. It appeals to us. We enjoy it. And yep, we will fall and give in every single time. And the good news is, what the good news has always been, masturbation is normal. Everyone does it. What's the big deal? None of this is meant to be embarrassing, for such is the nature of the sexual appetite. It is never satiated. We're all subject to concupiscence, and if you have to do it 100 times a day, then do it 100 times a day. There are only 24 hours in a day. For some of those hours, we're unconscious. It's called sleep, leaving a limited number in which everything revolves around personal bodily pleasure, and any other people that are present in the mind in this fantasy world are figments of the imagination or imagined versions of actual people. Moreover, because of the pleasure associated with this sexual release, you need to accept it and use it constructively when it does come into your life. Masturbation is actually an opportunity to grow. Nothing hard to grasp there. It is a fact that the human mind can only contain one thought at a time. When temptation comes, simply grab the crucifix and concentrate on it intensely. Masturbation, in some ways, has some very difficult hurdles built in. It's not surprising that many people, especially young people, but not just young people, fall into a habit of masturbation. It is, however, part of Catholic Church teaching, but almost never spoken of publicly. It's okay, everybody's doing it, no big deal. Now, some practical steps are to spend time in reflection, considering the circumstances of when the greatest times of temptations manifest themselves for us. For example, is it late at night lying in bed before sleep? How about waking hours? It may seem impossible to not give in, for such is the nature of the sexual appetite. It is never satiated. With the abundance of pornography on the internet, which provides near unanimous anonymity, guys can go and have sex with whoever they want, and girls can dress like prostitutes and make themselves targets for sex. And there are no better habits to practice than masturbation and pornography, especially internet porn. Why? Well, first of all the saints and angels, the whole heavenly court, is on your side. The only thing missing from all of this is you. And the good news is, what the good news has always been, that Catholic is the new cool. Yep, cool as in right, hip, awesome, rocks, C-O-O-L, cool. God love you. I'm Michael Voris.